एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द स्टार्ट ऑफ अ न्यू वीकेंड रीडिंग व्लॉग. सो दिस इज़ माय फर्स्ट व्लॉग, सो आई होप इट गोज़ वेल. सो टुडे इज़ फ्राइडे एंड आई एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड रीडिंग फ्रॉम दिस इवनिंग आफ्टर आई फिनिश माय ऑफिस वर्क. सो इट्स 11 PM. सो आई डिड रीड कपल ऑफ पेजेस इन द इवनिंग, लाइक व्हाइल आई वाज हैविंग टी. So far I've read 20 pages and it's quite good. I'm reading little fires everywhere, as you saw in the previous clip, and so far it's really good. It's I'm interested to see how it goes along, so it's not boring. And yeah, I'll keep you updated. It's 11 PM already, as I've mentioned, so let's see how much longer I can read. I'm a little sleepy now. But I will try to pull through. And yeah, I will update you later. Hey everyone, it's Saturday now. We're out and about. We're actually out to pick up some things for the house. And yeah, so I thought I'll vlog a little bit. I was thinking to bring my Kindle to read in the car, but then I didn't. So I've read about 50 pages, which is not a lot, I will say. But yeah, it's the novel is pretty good, quite engaging. I'm really liking a lot. I like the two characters, the dynamic between them, and the story is taking its turn. And let's see how it goes, and I will update you. Bye guys.
खराब कर दिया अंकल ने मेरा वीडियो.
Afternoon, so that means I finished the book. Yes, I finished it yesterday on Sunday night. I finished it completely, and I do have some thoughts on it, so let's just get right into it. So I'll give a brief summary about the book, and then I'll get into my thoughts and review on it. I read Little Fires Everywhere by Celeste Ng. I'll put up a picture here and there. So the book is set in this town called Shaker Heights in Ohio, and it is set in the 90s. So where this family called the Richardson lives, and they have lived there their whole life, and it is a planned town. Like everything from the schools to the color of their houses are planned. They have a rental home that they rent every year to someone or the other. And there comes a mother and daughter called Mia and Pearl, and they rent their home to them. So and these two are like the complete polar opposite of the Richardson family. So Mia, the mother, is an artist, and they have lived kind of a bohemian nomadic lifestyle their whole life, moving from town to town whenever inspiration hits her. So there are four children, and these children are like drawn to Pearl and Mia, the mother, and slowly their lives intertwine with each other. We see the friendship between Pearl and the Richardson kids grew. Pearl just spends all her time in Richardson house, and Mrs. Richardson, or Elena is her name, also hires Mia to do her household chores. So slowly and steadily their lives get intertwined, and that just sets a series of small events which lights little fires everywhere, which then just burns the whole house down. So I really liked the book. It was really compelling and engrossing, you know, drama. and the dynamic between the two women, Mia being you know, free spirited, and then there's Mrs. Richardson, who is so set by her rules and follows them everywhere, everything has to be planned. So that just contradicts everything. The book also deals, with motherhood, obviously motherhood, and then it also deals with relationships, with adolescence, with race. There's a subplot of a custody battle also with this interracial couple who has adopted a Chinese baby, and the baby's biological mother is fighting to get her child back, and that just separates the Mia and Elena like on two polar opposite sides, and that just, you know, ignites the fire more. You see how much people have changed, how their character have developed, and how those two have impacted their lives so passionately and so deeply. So it was a really great, compelling book. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars, and I will highly recommend that you read it. It's a great book, and yeah, let me also know your thoughts about it, and if you have read it, and please like, share and subscribe this video, and I'll be back with more reviews and more books, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.